number one. Okay, we are going to perform task number one in DID lab. So the question what I have given for task number one is being circulated to you through mail. I hope everyone has the question. I hope everyone has gone through the question. Okay, any volunteer get up and read the question. Any one student read the question. Please listen, everybody. Yes, start reading. Don't waste time.
Design and implement a digital circuit to convert the input code from one form of coded code to other code. Use n input logical elements, sum of product and or input logic. Assume n has 1, 2, 3 and so on. Use n input logic elements, product of sum or and invert logic. Assume n has 1, 2, 3 and so on. Using n input NAND gates, assume n has 1, 2, 3 and so on. Using n input NOR gate, assume n has 1, 2, 3 and so on.
Let us take the question number one, that is task number one. You have to convert from one form to other form, the code conversion. Let us assume that I am going to convert 84 minus 2 minus 1 mode to 84 to 1 code. Okay? So it is your responsibility to take a unique code, to be flexible, whatever code you are going to take, ensure that it is not been taken by any other student. Okay? That is the first criteria for solving this particular task number one. So you have to ensure. So what methodology you are following, you have to adapt it effectively and use the Google groups or all the digital medias to inform others that I have taken this particular code conversion. Okay. So 8421, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So I expect that you have to get from 0 to 9, 10 unique codes to represent 0 to 9 decimal number. Okay. So other cases you can treat as don't guess, it's up to you. So to reduce the complexity, you can treat as don't guess. So 0 to 9, I want the unique code represented in one form, which can be converted into other form. I want a hardware which will perform that. So what type of hardware we are going to do is SOP form, POS form, NAND based logic, NOR logic. So these are the four possible way of implementing your code converter circuit. We have to find out all the four possible ways, okay, theoretically, and we have to simulate all the four possible ways using any digital tool, either multisim or any other tool. And the best simplified circuit, that is the best simplified circuit has to be implemented in the hardware. Okay. I am not expecting that you have to implement all the circuits, you have to implement the best one in the hardware. So which is the best one you are going to decide. Okay. And you have to validate that. Whatever you are deciding, you have to validate. That is one important task. So 8, 4, minus 2, minus 1, let us take for 0. So I want to give for 0, it is 0, 0, 0, 0. For 0 in 8, 4, 2, 1, it is also 0, 0. 1, 0, 1, 1, 1. Here for 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. For 2, 0, 1, 1, 0. So what is our necessity is first to design any hardware we wanted to give. In the examination, whatever be the design question, if you refer the old question papers, you can see that surely 4 or 5 design questions will be there. First priority is you have to draw the truth table. Now they didn't mention that you have to draw the truth table. Truth table has to be drawn. And then you have to decide. Sir, I am not able to draw the truth table, then it is meaningless. Okay? Your design will not be validated. So to validate the design, you must have the truth table. A perfect truth table, after ensuring that it is correct, you go for K-map simplification or Boolean law simplification and then design the circuit. Okay? 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 3, 0, 1, 0, 1, here it is 0, 0, 1, 1, 4, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 5, 0, is 8, okay, 5, 8 minus 2, 6, 6 minus 1, 5, okay, so here 0, 1, 0, 1, 6, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 4, 5, 6, 0, 7, 8, minus 1, okay, here 7, 0, 1, 1, 1, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 plus 1, 7, 8, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 9, 1, 1, 0, 0, 4 plus 8, 12, 12 minus 2, 10, 10 minus 1, 9, here 1, 2, 7, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, based on the truth table, we are going to design a circuit. The truth table must be accurate. If you make a mistake in the truth table, the total design will be completely wrong. Sir, I did the mistake in the truth table. Please ensure the circuit is correct. It will not be validated. Truth table must be correct. Okay? In mathematics, if you say the formula is correct, final answer is wrong, you will not get the full mark. Similarly, the truth table is wrong means total experiment is wrong. The first step must be the best step. Okay, there must be no error in this particular development of truth table. Any doubt in development of truth table? Okay. After this, I am going to write the canonical form of SOP equations. How to derive the canonical form of SOP equations? We have to label the outputs. I am labeling the outputs as O3, O2, O1, O0. Inputs are I0, I1, I2, I3. Sir, why? What is the necessity of labeling? To derive the equation. The next step of our design is equation. So, in your examination, first you have to make the truth table, then you have to give the Boolean equation. After that, you have to work for simplification. Boolean equation can be designed using SOP form, POS form. Okay? SOP form, canonical form. First method is canonical form and sigma m. Sum of product terms. So, what are the terms we are going to write here? Let us assume O0. Okay, what is the value here? 1. Wherever it is 1, corresponding what is the value? 10. 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So, like that, you have to frame for, this is for O0, you have to frame for O1, O2, O3. Similarly, this is in POS, SOP form, POS, product of sum, because we want sum of product equation, product of sum equation, POS form. POS form, what will be the equation? Either from the truth table you can derive or from here you can derive. What is this?
Zero.
What are the terms we see?
0,
2,
6,
4,
6,
8. Okay? So remaining things you can consider as ground cash. You can put the ground cash for the remaining cases if you want. Okay? So ground cash, D stands for ground cash. Whatever you want, you can do it. So this way you have to make. After making this, you have to follow Boolean law. Simplification. Second method is K-map simplification. Both the simplification method must result from here. Okay? So if we just mismatching, you have to find out what is the error. R, which is the appropriate solution. Okay, so these things are to be done. So to understand this, we will take one example, 4-bit adder design. 4-bit adder, which we have studied in our 10th class to do manipulations. Binary arithmetic, 4-bit addition, we have done. So let us take what will be the maximum value for the two datas, 4-bit datas. Let us assume A is the first data and B is the second data. the maximum values in binary format is 111111. I'm going to perform this operation. So 1 plus 1, what is the value? 1 plus 1 is 0, is the sum, carry is 1. 1 plus 1 plus 1, sum is 1, carry is also 1. 1 plus 1 plus 1, sum is 1, carry is also 1. So what is the need of this particular operation? This particular operation is being done for manually determining how many outputs are required for my design. So if you observe, 4 inputs are being provided, but what is the number of outputs we require? 5 outputs for this. So I am going to label the inputs and outputs using Euclidean format A0, A1, A2, A3, B0, B1, B2, B3. I am going to perform the addition A0 plus B0, sum 0, carry 0, will be propagated to the next stage. I am going to perform the addition sum 1, carry 1, sum 2, carry 2, sum 3, carry 3. I am getting the labels. Okay, so this is the next step part. When I have been asked to design a 4-bit adder, I have to show this. So here, after this, you can make the truth table. So truth table, how many possible combinations will be there? Totally, how many our input bits are there? 8. So 2 power 8 combinations will be there, yes or no? 2 power 8 means what is the answer? 256 combinations will be there. So if you want to make the truth table for this, it is tedious. So how to do? You have to find out some digital tools to make that truth table. But in the laboratory, sir, in your theory examination, if the same thing asks, you can show some 3 or 4 sample manipulations, and you can say the remaining cases is similar to that. Okay, you have to find out if the number of elements in the truth table is exceeding some limit. Show some other alternative way to show the output. So you have to find some alternative way. The alternative way is, instead of making a truth table, you can show it manual calculation for samples. Okay, where there is no carry, where there is a carry, like that you can provide. So 5 or 6 samples is sufficient. That chain is more. Okay. So after this, now I have to determine the hardware. A0, B0. I can perform it using off adder, we have seen in the previous class. Yes or no? Off adder. Off adder, what will be the truth table for off adder? Off adder, inputs are A, B, sum and carry. 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. If you perform addition, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. This two tables will be there. What is the circuit for this? This is equal to sigma m. You will be having these two. That is 0, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Carry is equal to sigma m, 3. So to do this, you can have this circuit. That is A B bar plus A XOR B, which is equal to A XOR B. Okay, carry is equal to A B. So the diagrammatic representation will be A B. So if you are not able to draw the diagram clearly, you can mention it XOR gate below that. Current limiting resistor is the connector in the room. Red LED, green LED, where is it? This is for some carry. Wherever you are giving the connection, you give a 2 mark. That is, intersection is being made. Understood? This is the thing what we performed with the last week. Yes or no? Okay. Now, I want this done by half hour. What will be this one? 3 bit adder. It is nothing but a full adder. Again, I require a full adder. Full adder. Sir, what is this full adder? Full adder is nothing but 3 bit adder. Possible combination is 0, 0, 0. 001 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, 111. These are the possible combinations we can have. So if you perform this 0, 1, 1, 10, 1, 10, 10, 11. I am adding carry as 0 for the how I have got 0, 0, 0. You can do binary addition. Sir, I don't know binary addition. Perform decimal addition, convert into binary form. 0, 1, 1. This is 1, 1, 2. 1, 0 is the answer. 1, 1, 1, 2. 1, 0 is the answer. 1, 1, 2. 1, 0 is the answer. 1, 1, 1, 3. 1, 1 is the answer. That's all. Either you perform decimal addition or binary addition, the resultant must be binary form. Give the base. The examination base is very important. Whatever answer you are giving, the final answer must be with base. If it is not with base, it will be treated as invalid answer. 50% mark will be based on the base. Notations must be there. In your other subjects, you will be giving meter, centimeter, mathematics if you do. If you are not mentioning the unit, what happens? It is invalid. Similarly, here also the base is mandatory. You have to mention the base for the final answers. Okay? There is no unit means you have to mention the base. If there is a unit, you have to mention the unit. Okay, understood? Now for this, I am going to make the truth table, full adder. What will be the circuit? A, B, C. Sum and carry. Since C is there in the input, I am giving S and CY. Okay? Or I can have a CY here, yes sir. 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I have filled the truth table inputs. What will be the corresponding outputs? You can fill from here. 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1. Understood? You are filling the answer. What is the value of this? Sum is equal to sigma m. What will be the answer? So wherever it is 1. Okay, 1, 2, 4, 7. Carry. Sigma m. K-map technique as well as your Boolean loss interpretation. Let us start with the K-map technique. K-map technique, we are having the inputs as A, B, C. We can mention it as A, B, C. Zero, 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 0001.
Gray code conversion I have explained. One bit gray variation.
Okay, here also we are following the gray code value 1 1 1 0 0 1. Okay, this is one method. Another method is you can leave it in a vertical form. Zero 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 1 1 1 1 0. Any one method you can follow. So here 0, 0, 0, you write the binary decimal equivalent for it. 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 3, 0, 1, 0, 2. Here 1, 0, 0, 4, 1, 0, 1, 5, 1, 1, 1, 7, 6. Here I am filling 0, 1, 3, 2, 4, 5, 7, 6. Any doubt in filling this? Okay. Now from this sigma 1 2 4 7, now you can see the importance of canonical form. If you represent in canonical form, you can directly fill it. So 1 2 4 7, let's go to 1
2, 4, 7. 1, 4, 2, 7. Okay? So, here the power of 2 we can map. That is, you can group based on 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, like this. 2 power 0 is 1 element. 2 power 1, a pair. That is 2 elements. 2 power 2, 4 elements. 2 power 3, 8 elements. Okay? 2 power 4, 16 elements. Like that, we can grow our grouping mechanism based on the size of the K-map. This is a 2 cross 3 K-map. Similarly, 3 cross 3 K-map. Then 4 cross 3 K-map. 4 cross 4 K-map. 4 cross 5, 5 cross 4, 5 cross 5. Like that, we can grow our K-map. Okay? So, for this K-map, if I am going to group, if there is no concept of grouping, only this thing we can write. Okay? Or a single element. So now we have to find out some alternative methods to find the answer. Simplified answer. Let us take the sum. Sum is equal to, from this sum, 1, 2, 4, 7. I am going to fill the equation A, B, C. Okay? A, B. It is for the 0, 0, 1. So what is 0, 0, 1? 0, 0, 1 is 1. 0, 1, 0. It is equal to 2. Okay? So what is the value of here? A bar, B, C bar. Wherever it is 0, you put A bar. Wherever it is 1, you put B. Or the corresponding element, B, if it is B bar, if it is 0, it is to be B bar. Okay? So next thing is 4. 1, 0, 0. A, B, C. Plus 7, 1, 1, 1, ABC, okay? So, we are getting this equation. Now, using our laws, can we extract some common terms from this? Everyone have the laws as a homework, yes or no? Take down what law can be applied to extract the common terms. What is the common term here? A bar is a common term, B bar, C, plus B, C bar. Plus here common term is A, B bar, C bar plus B, C. What is this law? The last person get up. What is the law applied here? Get up. Last. What type of law there is? Where is homework? Bring it. Come out with your homework, man. Don't bring your homework. Next. What law?
Commutative law.
Correct law. What is it? Just define the law. Refer your notes and define, no problem. Where is your notebook, classroom notebook? You have to ask others and you have to do. Any class is there or not, you have to maintain the notebook. Next, sir, get up. Next member, tell me. The same thing, you just express the law. Yes, my proctor students, distributive law. Explain the law.
P of P plus C, P A B plus
H. Okay, understood. So refer the laws, you have to learn, but you have to mention it. Okay. So next, after this, what are the other laws we are having? Next to my proctor student, get up. What are the laws we are having? Associative law, distributive law, tell me the remaining laws. Refer your homework and tell me the laws there.